Hello students, in the previous class we have discussed about need of water and minerals for the plant for the various physiological processes like photosynthesis, transpiration, transportation and to maintain the turgidity or turgidity of the cells. Then after that we have discussed about the characteristic of root and root hairs for the absorption process. Today we'll discuss about the phenomena associated with the ascent of sap or the movement or the transportation of food materials from leaves to other part of the plant, from root to shoot, movement of water and minerals, and all these movements or transportations are related with various physiological phenomena, and that are basically these are the imbibition process, diffusion, osmosis, active transport, turgidity and flaccidity. So let's start with the first topic of today, that is imbibition. Imbibition is a surface phenomena for the substances that are hydrophilic in nature. Hydrophilic in nature. Basically, these substances are made up of cellulose or protein. Hydrophilic nature means strong affinity for water molecules. Affinity of water for water molecules results in absorption or soaking or imbibition of water from the surrounding to the cell. So that absorption process is associated with the attraction of water molecules by the cellulosic or protein cells or the protein substances. For this we'll take an example. First example is about seeds soaked in water. Seeds soaked in water. When we soak seeds in water after 2 or 3 days, we observe that seed coat swells up, resulting in rupturing of the seed coat, and the seedling germinates. So the process of germination is also associated with the imbibition process. Next to the example is swelling up of wooden doors in rainy season. Wooden doors, they are dead in nature, dead cells, but still these cells absorb water present in the atmosphere. During rainy season, the moisture content of the atmosphere is very high, so these cells, they imbibe water, they absorb water, and this imbibition results in swelling up of the dead cells of the wooden door, and which results in a disturbance or an obstruction in the movement of or the opening or closing of the wooden doors. Next topic for today is osmosis and diffusion. These two topics we'll discuss together, diffusion and osmosis. Diffusion number 3 is osmosis. Diffusion is the movement of molecules from higher concentration to lower concentration. The molecules may be solid, liquid or gaseous molecule. All three states of matter. This is applicable for all three states of matter, solid, liquid and gas. While osmosis is a process in which the molecules move from higher concentration to lower concentration, but this movement takes place in solvent or the liquid molecules only in solvent or liquid molecules. So this is a major difference between diffusion and osmosis. Otherwise, the movement of molecules is always from higher to lower. Sometimes students write, when they are writing about diffusion, they use the term that it is movement of molecules from high to low. In osmosis, they write the opposite of this, that low to high. No, both the process are same. The movement of molecules from higher to lower. In diffusion, all three states of matters are involved. In osmosis, only liquid state or the solvent molecules move from higher to lower. One major difference between these two is, in this there is no partition, no separation, but in this process, a semi-permeable membrane is must to be present between these two areas. So whenever a semi-permeable membrane, a parchment paper, animal bladder, or any kind of semi-permeable membrane, a separating membrane, a selectively permeable separating membrane is present between these two areas, high concentration or low concentration zone, then the process is osmosis. Otherwise, in both the phenomena, the movement is higher to lower. So this basically, that's why we have discussed these two together. Next is active transport. Active transport is just opposite of these two. Active transport means when the movement is against concentration gradient. Against concentration gradient means, in these two phenomena we have discussed that it is, the movement is always from higher to lower, but in this case it is lower to high. Low to high. When the movement is against concentration gradient, it requires energy. Energy is always in the form of ATP. ATP is adenosine triphosphate. So, requires energy in the form of ATP, which is adenosine triphosphate. We have discussed already that ATP, or where it is released, that is mitochondria, during the respiration process, ATP energy is released in the form of ATP. This use of ATP or energy for transportation is active transport. So it is different from diffusion and osmosis. Diffusion and osmosis is higher to lower. It is opposite of that, lower to higher. Against concentration gradient, utilizing energy of the cell. Next is, or the last topic of today, is turgidity and flaccidity. Turgidity and flaccidity. For this, I'm making a diagram. This is a cell. Another diagram to explain flaccidity. Suppose this is a cell. It is submerged or immersed in a solvent. In this, concentration of solute is high. When the solute concentration inside the cell is higher than the outside environment or outside surrounding area, then the water molecules move from outside to inside. It results in a phenomenon that is movement of molecules from surrounding to cell. Surrounding to cell. When this condition takes place, when the concentration of solute high in the cell. In the cell. So the movement of water will be surrounding cell to cell water movement. And this process of movement of water molecules from outside to inside is termed as endosmosis. Endosmosis. Next, when the concentration of solute is low in cell, low solute concentration as compared to the solvent, the movement would be from inside, movement of water molecules or sap would be from inside to outside. This process is termed as exosmosis. So, low solute concentration inside the cell. From cell to surrounding water movement. And this process is termed as exosmosis. But we have to discuss turgidity and flaccidity. We haven't discussed turgidity and flaccidity. These two terms are related with this. These processes. When endosmosis takes place, there is swelling up of cell. Swelling up of cell. Until a stage reaches when it cannot retain more water. And that stage is called the turgid stage. Or the cell is termed as turgid cell. The phenomena is termed as turgidity. The stage when the cell is fully filled with the cell sap, it cannot retain more water and after this stage, that is the turgid state and the phenomena is turgidity. In this case, it results in shrinkage of the cell. The process is exosmosis and the term used for this is flaccidity. Shrinkage of cell, the cell sap moves from inside to outside, the cell walls, the cell membrane shrinks, result and withdraws the cell wall. Withdrawing the cell wall results in shrinkage of the complete cell, or sometimes it results in plasmolysis. Plasmolysis is a new term for you that we'll discuss in the next video. And in the next video, I'll describe you the structures, how this phenomena takes place in the cells, that is turgidity or flaccidity, the pressure, wall pressure, all these terms related with the phenomena turgidity and flaccidity. Quick revision of these topics, imbibition, surface phenomena. Surface phenomena for the substances having strong affinity for water, diffusion and osmosis, movement of molecules from higher concentration to lower. In osmosis, semi-permeable membrane is must. Diffusion is for all three states of matter, while osmosis is for liquid state only. Active transport, movement of molecules against concentration gradient, utilizing energy. Turgidity and flaccidity. Turgidity is the stage when the cell is fully filled stage, or flaccidity is a condition when the cell wall, cell membranes shrinks due to exosmosis process. Thank you for today. In the next video, we'll discuss about these phenomena in detail. Thank you.